Hi there, and welcome to our channel. We're excited to have you here and can't wait to share our knowledge about technologies and tech-related trends. In this video, we will introduce you to different types of tokens, talk about the most effective token distribution methods, and provide examples of how popular blockchains allocate their tokens between stakeholder groups. Let's jump right in. The first question is, what are the four main types of tokens? These are utility, governance, security, and non-fungible tokens. With utility tokens, users can access certain goods and services, participate in staking and liquidity mining, join loyalty programs, and make payments. Governance tokens give users the right to propose and vote for or against ideas regarding platform development. Security tokens make it possible to tokenize real-world assets or company shares and enable users to invest in them. And finally, there are non-fungible tokens, or NFTs. They represent tokenized unique items that are not interchangeable. Users can buy, sell, or collect them through NFT marketplaces. Want to know more? Check out our previous video to learn more about this type of tokens and how to design tokenomics in general. Alright, let's get back to token allocation and find out how tokens are distributed. So, the most effective distribution methods are venture capital, airdrops, lock drops, rewards, and public sales. We're gonna start with venture capital. These days, venture capital firms are actively investing in crypto projects. The investment model is different from standard venture capital fundraising. Instead of acquiring equity, venture capital firms buy tokens. For example, in 2021, Solana Labs completed a private token sale of $314.15 million. The sale was led by Andreessen Horowitz and Polychain Capital. The firms purchased tokens, and Solana Labs used the funds to launch an incubation studio. This helped to accelerate the development of platforms based on Solana. Next token distribution method is airdrops. During an airdrop, a small portion of the tokens are sent to the wallet addresses of active users. Users just need to do some small action, like retweet a post or subscribe to a social media channel, and they will receive the tokens for free. Project creators choose to airdrop their tokens to draw public attention to their newly created platforms. It also helps build a strong community that will later keep the platform running and afloat. A lock drop, in its turn, works very differently from an airdrop. Before the release of new tokens, users of another network, let's say Ethereum, lock their ETH for a certain period of time. Once that period is over, users receive tokens from the new network as well as get those previously locked tokens back. The more they lock and the longer the lock period lasts, the more new tokens they will receive. Lock drops are suitable for those who are generally interested in the project because they have to make a commitment not to use their tokens right away. Then we have rewards. Platform creators reserve a large portion of native tokens to grow the ecosystem. Token rewards are included in that portion as well. For their long-term commitment to the project, users can get staking and liquidity provision rewards. They can also receive platform prizes, especially if it's a crypto game. As for public sales, initial coin offering ICO, initial exchange offering IEO, and initial DEX offering IDO are the three most common types here. While the popularity of ICOs has declined due to upsurge of scams, IEOs and IDOs are still on the rise when it comes to crypto project funding. Now, let's take a look at the real-life examples of token distribution. We will analyze how three successful blockchain platforms, Ethereum, Solana, and Polkadot, allocated their tokens during the initial token distribution. The first example is Ethereum. ETH's initial supply amounted to over 72 million tokens. 83.47% of them were purchased by investors, and 16.53% were distributed to the project founders and creators. The initial sale was held back in 2014. It helped the Ethereum Foundation raise over 31,000 Bitcoin, equivalent to $18.3 million at the time. The Solana blockchain launched its SOL token in 2020. The first 500 million SOL tokens were distributed through auctions and private sales. They also went through 5 funding rounds that raised over $25 million in total. 38% of the initial token supply was allocated in the form of airdrops and rewards. Investors received 37% and 25% was held by the project founders. Polkadot was launched in 2020. The initial supply of DOT tokens was 1 billion, and it went through 4 rounds of funding, 1 private and 3 public. The first ICO took place in 2017 and raised $80 million. The last one was held in 2020 and generated $42.76 million. As a result of these, investors received 58.4% of the initial token supply. The founders held 30%, and the rest, 11.6%, was allocated through rewards and airdrops. And that's it for today. Have you thought about launching your own token? Share your opinion on which token distribution methods you find the most effective. If you want to know more about tokenomics, blockchain, and other innovative technologies, visit our Pixelplex blog. Thank you for watching our video. Like, subscribe, and enjoy our next videos. Stay tuned. Bye.